Today, Group C9 has gathered here to do a brief presentation on the financial analysis of conglomerates in Sri Lanka. The conglomerates of our country, it is actually quite a thriving industry, which has diversified into multitude of other sectors. Here, for the assignment's purpose, we have specifically focused upon four groups of companies. They are Heyris PLC, Softlogix, John Keells Holdings and Akin Spence. Out of those four companies, we selected Heyris PLC to be our main company, and then we would compare its financial performance against the other three companies, that is mainly by using a ratio analysis. If I have to give a brief description on Heyris, it was founded in 1878 and it has expanded its product portfolio into so many sectors such as textiles, leisure, agriculture, plantation, consumer and retail, transportation and logistics, and so on. With a total workforce of around 32,000 employees, Heyris has manufacturing facilities in India, Indonesia, and Thailand, while it also has marketing operations in Australia, India, Bangladesh, Japan, Italy, and the Netherlands. So in this particular slide, it basically shows the market positions held by Heyris, where it basically dominates certain market sectors. At the latter part of the presentation, we would also brief you on the non-financial aspects of Heyris. Now, my colleague Amila would take you through the financial analysis part of the presentation.
Thank you, Pramodita. I will take you through the Heyris PLC financial analysis with the use of last 5 years' financial results. Basically, I will focus mainly four areas in order to do the financial analysis: profitability, liquidity, gearing and market, as well as investor returns. Those are the four areas which we have focused under the financial analysis. Under the profitability, when you take the profitability margins of the company, in terms of GP margin, they have maintained between 22% to 25% during the last 5 years. Especially in the last financial which we have focused during the 2018-19, they have slight increment also, despite the fact that they have charged interest cost with the acquisition of Singer PLC due to the group during the year, as well as with the use of smart cost management techniques which they have used against the rupee devaluation, as well as the diversified contribution to the operating profitability, which has been resulted to better earnings in terms of operating profitability. When you take the financial cost of the company has been increased due to all the acquisitions have been funded with debt finance. With that, their financial cost has been increased, and due to that, net profitability has been reduced during the last financial year. In terms of profitability on capital assets, they have a big asset base, but with that acquisition strategies, they have not unleash their potential yet, and they are in the process of generating results. With that, their return on total assets and ROC has been slightly declined. In terms of liquidity, with the funding capital of debt finance, short-term portion has been increased, and with that, their liquidity has been slightly come down. But with the use of effective working capital techniques which they have used, especially in the 2019-20 results, with the latest results when you check, they have improved in the last financial year. As I explained in the previously, their gearing and debt has been increased due to their aggressive acquisition strategies which you have funded with debt finance, and their gearing and debt has been considerably increased. Therefore, their financial risk has been impacted to their profitability as well as their operational results. When you take the market investor returns, their controlling interest moved drastically in the last two financial years, and their non-controlling interest has been increased, and profit attributable to the equity holders of the company as the conglomerate, their holding company, has been reduced. With that, their earning per share and earnings yield has been reduced, but in terms of dividends yield, they have maintained up to certain level. when you take the net assets per share, as I explained previously, their asset base has been increased and their net assets per share has been drastically increased. When you take the PE ratio, that that exceeds the their earning potential of the company, their market price has been reduced, but that has not been reduced up as according to the earnings per share. Both ratios has been reduced, but due to their variation in the declining rates, their PE ratio has been increased. That shows their earning potential. Market price of the share has been impacted, the market sentiments of the company, and as a conglomerate, they have maintained steady results during the last financial years or the which you have been considered. With that, I would like to invite my colleague Kasun and Chamira for to the non-financial aspects.
Thank you, Amitha. Non-financial performance also utmost important for a company such as financial performance. So we will be discussing about the Heli's non-financial performance. And the main focus areas will be the unique way the Heli's handling this business. They call it Heli's way. And customer and supply relations, and also the carbon footprint reduction. And
also in the investment in CSR, group tech knowledge, vast portfolio like that. When it comes Heli's way, culture is very, very important for any organization to identify who are they to at society. For especially Heli's company perform at financial activities and non-financial activities, and they have gained a good view, good feature, and good identity from society, engaging stakeholders, employees, engaging utility business, deal with doing the CSR activities for environmental, dealing with consumers, corporate responsible, public activities, and regular compliance.
And let's talk about people that work at Heli's. And in 2020, they had 31,000 employees. Compared to 2019, it's like only 0.1% reduction. And so, and in this case, and Heli's, even with the pandemic, Heli's keep like a really good numbers with their employee payroll. And also they have 4,651 of new recruits of that year. And also have invested 68 million during 2020 as a training and investment. And out of all these people, the diversity wise, 25% of them are executives. Out of that 25, 11% female percentage in managerial level, 62% male, and there is 38% female participation in labor force as well.
When it comes to community engagement, Heli's need to engage communities to keep their business at good way, also like a sustainability. So therefore, they want to do a CSR activities, especially from 2018 to 2020, January. They have increased CSR activities from out of 273, and beneficiaries of CSR increase around 418,000. Also, they have introduced new products. It has been increased. Heli's, as well as they have used R&D activities. They have invested a lot of money to R&D R&T activities to increase their CSR activities. Like also in community next engagement, especially COVID pandemic situation, they have given 9,000 face masks for society. Also, they have given 1,000 rubber gloves as a donation and 3.5 million worth medical instrument to donate to IDH hospital. As well as we can say, Purathi Satyadivara going to BI, they have consecutive fourth year and 11 schools, 2,674 children. They have given some benefit to school.
Yeah, as a commitment for environment, Helis has reduced 1% of energy consumption in 2020, and also to a 43% of their energy in 2020 has generated by renewable energy. And also they have planted 180,000 of trees during the 2020, and that's 4% of decrease of their carbon footprint. It seems like Helis has been doing very competitive compared to their competitors and with other conglomerates. And so their numbers of the non-financial area is very good as the financial area. And we would like to talk about corporate governance as well.
When it comes to corporate governance, chairman has involved to their operation, like with the operation department. Also, audit committee is very, very important to financial sector. There are non-executive directors involved into audit activities. Especially out of them, the chairman of audit committee is selected through independent chairman, and those information finally share with managing directors, internal audit, like that. Next, the warmly income, we need to do it next part.
Competitor analysis. Thank you.
Let's see how competitor has performed. For the competitor analysis, we have identified SoftLogic PLC, John Keynes PLC, Ethical Spence PLC as a competitors from Helis PLC. First current ratio, which measures company's ability to pay its current liabilities out of current assets for the next business cycles. And you can see JKS has the highest current ratio among other three conglomerates, which is more than 2 and 3 over the last 5 years, and which implies that they has good ability to pay its current liabilities out of the current assets. Thereafter, Helis PLC, SoftLogic and Ethicals PLC also has the fine current ratio throughout the last 5 years. However, SoftLogic current ratio is below 1, which is not a good healthy position for SoftLogic PLC, and which implies that they does not have enough current assets to pay its liabilities. When it comes to the quick asset ratio, likewise, current ratio, JKH has highest quick asset ratio out of the other three conglomerates, which is more than 2% over the last 5 years. This, the main reason for that, JKH has supermarket chains, and they has their revenue is mainly based on the cash sales, and they manage inventory well. Thereafter, Aitken Spence also shows fine quick asset ratio over the last 5 years. However, both Helis PLC and SoftLogic PLC maintain their quick asset ratio below 1%, which is not a good healthy position for the companies. Third ratio is debt to equity ratio. The lowest ratio is the most healthiest for the investors and creditors with the perspective of their risk. And you can see most healthiest debt to equity ratio belongs to the JKS, which is more than 1 over the last 5 years, and the lowest lines belongs to the JKH. And when we consider in the most unfavorable debt to equity ratio, which belongs to the Softlogic PLC, they are at the most highest position in the graph. In considering the interest cover ratio, which measures the company's ability to pay their interest payments with reference to the debt commitments, and you can see in this table shows JKS has more than two digits intercompany ratio over the last 4 years, except the 18 and 19. However, their interest cover also reduced to the 8 times in the 18-19 years. And in considering the Haley's PLC, Aitken Spence PLC, and Softlogic, they maintain 5 interest cover ratio throughout the five years, which implies that they have enough operating profit to cover the interest commitments. Fifth ratio is gross profit margin and operating profit margin. Haley's, JKH, Softlogic, all three conglomerates maintain their average throughout the last 5 years. Haley's approximately 23%, JKH approximately 25%, and Softlogic 33%. And according to the 18 financial statement of Aitken Spence PLC, there does not represent the gross profit margin in their gross profit in their financial statement. When it comes to the operating profit margin, JKH has highest of operating profit margin. Second, Aitken Spence has averagely 9% operating profit margin throughout the year. Haley's also has 7% operating profit margin. And this operating profit margin could be vary according to their market segment. Now I would like to invite Hasun to explain other ratios for the competitors.
In net profit margin, JKH and Softlogic is maintaining net profit margin around 15%, but Haley's is maintaining the ratio around 4%. In ROCE, Haley's, JKH and Softlogic are maintaining healthy ROCE ratio compared to Aitken Spence. When we compare the earning per share ratio, the Haley's had a good run up to 2018, but which has been decreased in 2018 mainly due to decrease in earnings. When we compare dividend per share ratio, both JKH and Haley's are paying a good dividend for their shareholders. In PE ratio, the PE ratio has been significantly increased in 2019 of Haley's mainly due to the reduction in earnings. So, according to this financial analysis, competitor analysis, so John Kills is holding the number one position among these four companies, but Haley's has the potential to be the best conglomerate in Sri Lanka by optimizing revenue of their existing entities as well as by acquiring new good companies in future. Thank you very much.